It's on the news at 1. The South African Federation of Trade Unions has called on South Africans to partake in a day of national action to bring the country to a standstill. Trade Union NUMSA is supporting the strike. The economic freedom fighters have also issued their support for this day of action. Trade Union Fedusa has, however, called the strike irresponsible. For more on this, I'm joined by Dennis George from Fedusa. Thanks so much for your time on SABC News. Why are you not supporting the strike?
Look, I think if a person looks at what is the intention and the purpose of the strike, then it's almost like we can say that the train already left the station, because the national minimum wage have been negotiated through government, business and labor in NATLAC for the last 2 years. And during that period, you know, the president pushed labor and business very, very hard, because we wanted to make sure that we're going to put in a minimum wages that's going to make a meaningful impact in the lives of our people. And when we look at the numbers, you would see about 4.6 million people earn less than the minimum wages of 3,500 per month. And that was the big motivation for us to even push government, you know, and business harder. But unfortunately, we pushed against a situation of costs. And the minimum wages will also be a cost for companies, and that is a reality that we have to face.
People are saying that this proposed 20 rand a minimum wage is exploitative and it's not going to give people a good quality of life, because it's going to work out to around 3,200 rand per month.
Yes. Look, the first thing is this. We have consulted with the University of Cape Town, and they brought out the numbers, what is for the national a living wage. So the difference between the living wage and a minimum wage is quite vast. But what we felt we need to do is to start somewhere. And many other countries have started 20, 30 years ago. And South Africa, if we started in 1995, the issue of poverty and unemployment would have not been so high. But we have been dealt with the situation as it is now. And this is very important for us, you know, to give the correct information through to our people. But there's many other things that government and business can do to lighten the burden on the poorest people in our society. But we also believe that the introduction of the minimum wages is something that's in the national interest, and it's something that's going to benefit 4.5 million people in our country.
Some of the commentary that's come out around this issue is that in order to get rid of the systemic patterns of poverty in South Africa, there needs to be a change and a shift away from the exploitative labor system that colonialism and apartheid built the economy on. Now, how do we do this if people are just living above the breadline and just living on this proposed 20 rand?
Yeah, look, the first thing that you must accept, that we have been given a tough task to fulfill. In the first place, you must remember we've got about 12 million people in South Africa that is not in employment, and those people are now recipients of the social grants that we are paying out, and that takes quite a big chunk from the money that government has available for education and also for health. And the introduction of the national minimum wage is another instrument to help to make sure that we have our people not being paid salaries that is so low that they can't make a living from. And that is why it is critical for us to have made this particular start. We are also not happy with the 3,500, but it's a start. And now from here, we will also release the regulations. And as the years goes forward, we can also now make sure that we can give our people above inflation increases on that minimum wages so that they can come quicker to the situation of a living wage. Mm.
Just speak to us briefly about these interactions that you have with the different unions. When I was speaking to Pakamile Hlubi a few weeks ago, I think she was referring to you as one of these sellout unions. So how do you move forward as people who are championing workers' rights if as a union base you're not united?
Yeah, look, the situation is SAFTU is a breakaway trade union from KUSATU. And you normally have a situation where there's a breakaway grouping, then they always want to be seen in public to be now the superheroes and the champions. But KUSATU, Fedusa and NAFTU, we have worked very, very hard over the last 2 years to make sure that we can give our people minimum wages. And I must also congratulate the president, because he was prepared to offer up his Sundays and Saturdays with academics, that we can make sure that we're going to put a package on the table of a national minimum wages that's going to help us. And this is going to take our country forward, but it will also mean, you know, that we also have to do other things to grow our economy, to get more people into employment, and to take South Africa forward, because the current situation that we have with unemployment that is so high and growth that is so low, we need to turn this thing around, and that is what must be our focus in the next few months, looking up to the job summit and looking at the investment summit also.
Dennis George from Fedusa, thanks so much for your time on that story. We're going to continue following that story. As you can see, SAFTU is taking part in that National Day of Action. Zwelinzima Vavi was speaking a brief moment ago. Let's take a look at those visuals.